Welcome back to the Rush Hour. My name is Mubarak Mugabo, and of course, the new vision is out on the market at 2,000 Uganda shillings. You can grab yourself a copy of the new vision. Over 12,000 schools to be renovated, and of course, over 120 billion shillings earmarked for the project. List of beneficiaries, districts inside today's new vision, and also new vision at 38. Celebrations are on page 2. You can actually grab yourself a copy of the new vision and find out what exactly happened. I'm seeing the deputy, the CEO and the board chair, editor-in-chief and deputy CEO are here celebrating and certainly cutting a cake for marking new vision at 38. Also, a very interesting conversation and also a wedding of the former Saint Savio brother weds in, and of course, walks down the aisle here on page 8. And also a chairperson of the Committee on State Authorities and State Enterprises, also Busiro MP, that's Medad Lubega Segona, lost 118 million Uganda shillings at a washing bay. Oh my God. How do you take 100 millions and 18 at a washing bay? For what purposes? And of course, on page 6, the details. How did he lose the money? Grab yourself a copy of the new vision. And also, Museveni rallies Dokolo for Adong. Now, the by-election is to take place tomorrow. That is going to happen. And of course, there are about 7 candidates to replace the late Honorable Cecilia Atim Ogwal. And of course, that conversation is going on in today's new vision. Very many stories inside the new vision. And of course, you can grab yourself a copy of the new vision at 2,000 Uganda shillings if you're in Uganda. In Kenya, 107 Kenyan shillings. And in Tanzania, you have to have about 1,600 Tanzanian shillings. And also in Rwanda, 933 Rwandan francs. Now, Toto Magazine is also in today's new vision. Grab yourself a copy of the new vision. You will be able to get that free copy of the new vision. Now, before we actually continue with that, also Bukede is on the market at 1,000 Uganda shillings. Chichi Echinyuaka Miri, just get a copy of Bukede at 1,000 Uganda shillings. You'll be able to get that yourself a copy of Bukede from all our vendors and outlets across the country. Now, we want to look at, of course, what is happening in the country. Heat waves and, of course, temperatures in Uganda are souring beyond 30 degrees Celsius. And, of course, it has not been actually normal. In South Sudan, schools closed down. And in Northern Uganda, the reports we received is that, of course, some students are finding it very hard to stay in school and in class while the heat is actually, and of course the temperatures are going up. We want to have an explanation from the experts, and we are lucky to be joined by Lilian Nkwenge, is the spokesperson of the Uganda Meteorological Authority. Thank you so much for joining me this morning.
Thank you so much for having me as well. I'm very happy to be here this morning.
You didn't come with a portable fan.
I thought that you'd come with the temperatures are still low. They are still low.
What explains this heat wave in the country and certainly in the region?
Thank you very much. First of all, they are not heat waves. Mm. This is a term that has come in the country, especially basing on what is happening in other countries.
Yes.
Our country has not yet reached a situation where are we having heat waves. First of all, let me talk about a heat wave. A heat wave is where you have temperatures that are above 40 degrees Celsius, mm-hmm. and that should have run, like, for instance, maybe a week or so. Mm-hmm. That one now,
that would qualify,
that amount
yes.
qualifies mm. it to be a heat wave. But here currently we are having raised temperatures.
Yes.
Temperatures are rising more than normal. And it's making people uncomfortable. I just wanted to clarify that.
Okay.
They're not heat waves, they're just high temperatures.
How long is this going to take? And what explains this rise in temperatures?
What is explaining this is that, first of all, we are in a rainy season.
Yeah.
Yes.
Where do you stay?
This is supposed to be Indian? This is supposed to be a rainy season.
But it is not.
It is March, we call it March to, uh-huh. to May, March, April, May season. And this is where we do a lot of agriculture in this country. Mm-hmm. It is the second rainy season in the country. And the first one is the this is the first one, then the second one is September, October, November, December. Those are the seasons where we plant crops and get food. Unfortunately, this season of March, April, May normally has a lot of interruptions. You know, weather is something that is interesting. You do not rely only on what you have in your country. We get a lot of systems that are coming in from different areas that affect our situation or our weather conditions in the country.
Yes.
Yes, currently, as I was telling you, we're supposed to be in a rainy season, but we happen to get a tropical cyclone in the Indian Ocean, which swept all our moisture that was supposed to come to the East African region. And it went down south. And that is the reason why you see we do not have rain in the rainy season. And when we were releasing the seasonal forecast, we had anticipated this and we told farmers that we are going to have interruptions of dry spells during this season. And this is the reason why. Then, of course, there are also other systems. We have the Arabian winds, which are blowing, coming from the east, coming this season. They bring a lot of dry conditions. And then we also have the situation whereby the sun is now above the equator for some days. So this one has created shortage of rain, first of all, and then now these conditions bring in the dry conditions, which has raised the temperatures.
So it has got nothing to do with how we handle our environment, because usually they tell us that you have cut down the trees and you have destroyed the environment. That's why actually you're suffering this way.
Yes. By the way, there are so many factors coming in. Probably I would think that even if we are having all these conditions from the different oceans, and probably if we had more trees, something would be different. Yes. So that one is also a factor. The climate change factor is also there. Although we are talking about systems coming in and disrupting our conditions, I'm just thinking that what if we had all sorts of forests that we used to have in the past, probably they would be generating some little rain and wouldn't be dry as we are now.
Oh, so in other words, because we have encroached on those, you know, that environment, that's why actually we are having this kind of,
the
troubles just come
to
us directly.
It's a contributor, it's a very big contributor. Yes, it's a contributor.
How long is this going to take? Because it looks like we can no longer sleep with our blankets on.
It also saves us. It's good to change once in a while. We are looking at the systems. Uganda National Meteorological Authority, one thing that we do is that we keep monitoring these conditions, the drivers that drive our weather conditions. We keep monitoring. And one of the things that is happening now is that we are seeing that the cyclone and the things that have been affecting us are now dying down. And we're expecting to get rains beginning again, at least by the end of this month.
Oh, by the end of this month.
Some places have started getting rains. I don't know whether you've heard that.
Does that mean that rain comes with a reduction in temperatures, or this time around
Definitely,
could be different?
Yes, it is going to come with a reduction.
Because in some countries we have heard that it doesn't matter whether it rains or not. It will certainly remain hot if it's hot.
Yeah, true. But our conditions here in Uganda, as I was saying, much as we are also being affected by so many things, the climate change and what, we've not yet gone to that level. At least we still have cool conditions. And the conditions that we are talking about here, like for instance, I was looking at our stations. We collect data from all around the country. Our stations, I was seeing that the highest temperatures were 38.8 degrees Celsius, and that was in
38
in our station in Wadelai. In Northern Uganda.
Yes. Is that West Nile?
You know, that is not West Nile. That is mid...
Greater North.
Greater North, yes. And that is the reason why you're talking about the high conditions, the very high temperatures in the north.
Yes.
Then also we also had 35.5. That was in Pakwach. That was the highest Pakwach, Soroti, and Guru. But now when you look at these temperatures, in contrast to, for instance, Sudan.
Yes.
If Sudan had 35 degrees.
People would be in a party.
They
would be in a party.
They would celebrate and say, "Oh, this is the best."
So in Kampala, we haven't gone beyond 30.
No, at one point we went at 31.
Okay.
But of course, because our conditions are so good, this country has very good weather. So when it comes like to 28, 30, there people become very uncomfortable.
Yes.
Look at your body temperature when you have malaria. What temperatures do you
ha, want? Do I even?
when
36.
For you, no, 36 is normal.
Yes.
Normal body temperature.
Yes.
The doctor will give you a card and say, go home and there's nothing. Go and party. But when it comes to around 38.
Yes.
Now the doctors start get worried. For us adults, for instance, a child can play around with about 40 degrees, a temperature of 40 degrees.
40, yes.
Yes, and they will be around there, but hot. So that is why I wanted to compare. That when you are around like 38 degrees and you have that kind of temperature,
okay.
You really feel a bit sick, you feel a bit hot. Even someone will touch you and say, I think this is not normal temperature.
You mentioned about climate change, and many of actually Ugandans say it's a hoax.
How can I don't believe this?
It's a very, interesting conversation, by the way, on our internet, on our social media, and even in many places you go to, they will tell you, these are meant to happen.
That it is that one I don't really understand, because really, okay, probably let me look at the younger generation. Would I be right to say that maybe they have not seen forests? They grew up and they don't know forests.
Forests.
Resistance.
The young generation. Where would you find the generation today? If you're a forest today now.
That's the problem.
Maybe
that's the issue.
Maybe
now.
Centenary Park.
That's not a forest. Ladies and gentlemen, the young generation, that is not the forest. Those are just trees to shelter you for as you go to rest or something. But we used to have forests.
Yes.
Very deep forests in this country. Thick. In various parts of the country. And those wherever those forests were, would always get rains. Definitely. I don't want to go into the science.
Yes.
But that is what used to happen.
Yes.
We had a lot of wetlands. And this one, somehow you'd find that the environment there is cooler and what? We no longer have the wetlands. You can see this kind of heat. Everybody is crying. I don't think it's normal. It used never to happen.
Yeah.
So when someone says that climate change is just a hoax, that I don't understand. Probably we need to read hard and also know, you know, if you do not know what is happening to you and you do not acknowledge that there is a problem, then that problem becomes even bigger.
You knew about this and you warned the country about this. What interventions did you suggest to policymakers and to government to ensure that actually we can as well deal with this kind of temperatures?
Of course, when you are giving advisories like for this season, we were mainly looking at what was going to happen when the rains are on. One of the things that happened during this season, the March, April, May, we normally have a lot of disasters. We normally have a lot of floods.
Yes.
And the beginning of the season, normally we have a lot of heavy winds. We have heavy winds. We normally have these thunderstorms, and people's things are normally destroyed, crops, buildings, and that kind of thing. It has happened as in some places I think you've seen.
Yes.
Kalangala you saw the other time in Hoima. Yesterday they told me there were very strong winds in the west. So houses and what were destroyed. So those were the things that we are looking at. Because these are major, they affect people's lives. They affect people's livelihoods. A building gets off and finds children and maybe hit them.
Yes.
The roofs, the children die. Those are the things that we are looking at. And when we're releasing this forecast, we had the office of the Prime Minister, because they're the ones that are charged with disasters. So they were there and we gave advisories basing on what we're expecting in this season.
Looks like we don't take them seriously. Do you sometimes feel like, when we want these people, you know, sometimes when you tell us it is going to rain and it doesn't, we say,
And normally, there's also that issue.
Yes.
First of all, as I was beginning, I think I gave you a statement that we depend, weather depends on so many things around us. For instance, I'll tell you, say that it is going to rain in Kampala. And you are here at the buildings at New Vision.
Yes.
When it doesn't rain here,
you say, go
downtown, you'll find flood.
Just like you said, it's a rainy season, and I was like, where do you stay? But actually, there could be places in Kampala where it's raining.
Yes, it's been raining. Actually, in Kampala, we've been benefiting from the Lake Victoria Basin.
Yes.
We've been getting some rains. That is the reason why you see that, like, for instance, up north, there are a lot of higher temperatures than here. Here you're crying, but really we've been benefited from this. Most of the times we've been having some light showers along the Lake Victorian Basin. That is from the east, the Jinja coming,
Jinja,
in,
yes.
the Masaka, the central here. We've been benefiting from some. Sometimes it's not raining, but at least it's cloudy, and you get some bit of, you know, relief. But there are other people who have been just hit without even a single drop of rain.
What do we need to do as we are winding up to ensure that we are not heavily affected by this kind of temperatures?
At an individual level, when you're talking about these temperatures, of course, it depends on how you're looking at it. As I was saying, at 28 degrees, I could even use my blanket or my duvet. But while another person says no, I am even removing my nightie.
Yeah.
So it also depends. But then, of course, in this...
These days when thieves come home, they will find you... It's not easy. It's not easy.
But actually, instead of fighting for your things, you'll be fighting for
your things. Before actually you continue with that, you're going to continue with the interventions.
Yes.
It comes with very fresh and very nice winds. What? How does that? What explains that then?
I've told you that we are having an issue, which is called the Arabian semi-permanent high pressure system, which pushes here hot and dry winds.
Oh,
it is hot,
yes.
But you still feel some wind.
Yeah, some wind, and it's really fresh.
Yes. So that is one of the reasons why.
Absolutely, you can continue with the recommendations.
It also depends on individuals, but definitely during this time, definitely people are dehydrated.
Yes,
let's drink a lot of water. Try to put on some things here.
I know people who are like selling people who are selling water don't want the rains to come.
I know.
When you go like downtown.
These things have advantages and disadvantages. Oh my God, we are taking water.
Yes.
I'm not a very good water drinker, but yesterday I was...
The sales of those companies are now...
I was shocked. I took 2 liters,
one and a half.
Of them. I couldn't believe that was me. So that is happening.
Yeah.
Of course, we also have to look at the diseases that are coming with these winds, the dry conditions. People are coughing.
Yes, cough and flu and
cough
all
and
that.
Flu and those kinds of things. And of course, when we have those winds that have a lot of dust in them, also these cases of asthma and what also can raise. But of course, when we're doing advisories, we are with the Minister of Health, so I'm very sure that they are prepared for this.
Have you reached a point of advising the ministry to close down some schools, especially in the northern Uganda, near South Sudan? Because yesterday I was actually watching some news story from our reporter, and it is becoming extremely hard for some of those actually children to stay in classrooms, especially when it's when you know, during day. Have you reached a point of saying, I think some schools should go back home?
We go back to the issue of heat waves. We have not reached a point of getting heat waves.
At these what heat point waves would you certainly say?
Of course, when
at
people 40? Start getting, like, when we have 40, above 40, constant for some days, then that means even our skins will start changing, people will start getting wounds, people will start getting, you know, these heat waves even sometimes cause heart attacks for people who have high blood pressure. So really I feel that for us we are resilient. I think we have not yet reached that condition, and the good thing is that at least it is easing. So definitely we're going to go back to our normal temperatures.
You're talking about today is actually 20th.
Yes.
And you're saying
so
that the rains are coming at the end of this month. That could be certainly.
At the end of the month, yes.
Meaning that we should expect the rains in the coming few days.
Yes, yes. And as I was saying, some places have already started getting the rains.
Within the central region?
Within the western.
Within western Uganda.
Within the eastern. Places like Kigezi Highlands have never stopped having rains. They've been having rains. The eastern, some parts of the Lake Victoria Basin, been getting rains. I've been talking to some journalists and they were saying, my beans are still okay. That kind of thing. So, some places. But the seasonal rains are coming back. This was just an interruption of a dry spell.
Okay.
Due to the conditions that I've talked about in the Indian Ocean. And we are sure that, and we are praying that this system continues, it dies down completely so that really we can go on with our lives.
Yeah. So in other words, you're saying that the rains are coming. Are they coming in a normal way, or are we experiencing
El Niño? They're going to be disastrous.
Really?
They are going to be disastrous because of the winds, as I've told you. This season is normally very difficult for us to predict. It has so many interferences. And when we're beginning the season, we advise that we are going to have a lot of disasters, especially due to the winds and the heavy rains. When they are beginning, they become like they come with a big force.
So we expect floods, yes, landslides during.
Definitely, if the rains, for instance, in the areas that are supposed to be having that are disaster prone, if the rains are severe, that means that is also there.
So let's wind up this conversation.
Thank you so much. Data.
Are you getting data? Are you still buying data, or our satellite is there?
No. For us, yes, at Uganda National Meteorological Authority, we have different things that that we use. First of all, we have stations across the country.
Yes.
As I was telling you, I was looking at the data here that came in from Wadelai, that is up north.
Yes.
Of course, neighboring and our sister country, which is very hot. We are talking about Pakwach, Soroti. We have networks.
I thought
we
you were depending on satellite data from actual other countries.
No, we have never.
You are using our local stations.
We have our local stations because you cannot get data from elsewhere to come and tell you what is going to happen in Kampala.
Mm.
No, we have a station in Makerere whereby we are going to see how much rain we are receiving, and that is going to determine how much rains we are going to expect.
Mm.
We have that kind of data. So we have stations from across the country. Now we have three radars. Weather radars, I don't know whether we've seen them, these very huge things, very beautiful. One day you should come and visit and see, which gives us, actually it gives us coverage across the whole country. One is in Rwampara, another one is in Entebbe, and it covers 500 kilometers, square kilometers.
That will be
each
across the border.
Then, of course, we also have another one in Lira. So even across, if we wanted to give data even to
across
Kenya,
the
what,
border, yes, you can
Rwanda,
supply.
Burundi, yeah, we could do that. But of course, that one is at a regional level, because
have you notified the ministry, the office of the prime minister, that actually we are likely to have disasters this coming season?
Whenever we are going to do this downscale, we call it downscaling. We normally have a regional forecast. We call it Greater Horn of Africa Climate Outlook Forum. We do that regionally. Then each country comes and downscales. So when we are downscaling, we have the office of the prime minister, minister of health, minister of agriculture, all those entities that are supposed really that are affected by weather related, that are weather related or dependent, you find that we are together, we sit down and do advisories, so they know, they're in the know.
Absolutely.
Recently, so I think we had like about three doctors from Ministry of Health, from KCCA, they were with us, and we sat down and looked at the conditions and what they are likely to bring and how they should prepare. So was Office of the Prime Minister.
All right. The takeaway I've got is that we are expecting rains in the next few days.
Yes, please.
If you are not able to see the rains, please call. We shall link you to Lillian to explain why you have not been able to make. Anyway, thank you so much, Lillian, for sparing time to speak to us. And of course, we want to look at, of course, what is happening elsewhere. And Uganda is to conduct the national census in the next 2 months. That is coming in May. What does it mean, and what importance should it actually carry to have a national consensus conducted? Why should government know the number of people in the country? Are we still 45, 48, 50, or less, or more? Those are the questions that are going to be answered after this very short break. Good morning.